This is also applicable to all other members who speak not more than 5 minutes for everybody. This I am telling. Now, a government minister will respond. That they will decide. It is joint responsibility. Don't worry. You are responding as if you are a minister. You are responding already. Then if you can respond, why don't they? Now, Sri T.G. Venkatesh. T.G. Venkatesh. Only 5 minutes. Eh?
7 minutes, sir.
Yeah.
50 minutes will make 7 minutes.
Yeah.
Respect.
That's why I restricted 5 minutes.
At the outset, I would like to convey my proposal.
Okay, let me speak.
Thanks to the Honorable Chair for giving me the opportunity to express my opinion on Andhra Pradesh Reorganized Bill 2016. Andhra Pradesh was divided in an unscientific manner, giving the MPs of Andhra Pradesh no chance to raise their voice. The then government had given no scope for discussions in the House. All the efforts of Andhra MPs had gone waste and state was divided. Discussions on the AP reorganization bill took place in Rajya Sabha only. While speaking on the AP reorganization bill, the Honorable Prime Minister assured on the floor of the House that once the state is bifurcated, the residual state of Andhra Pradesh would be accorded special category status for 5 years. Sri Venkaiah Naidu ji, Honorable Minister of Urban Development, who was in the opposition at that time, extended the support to the bill, demanded the special category status to Andhra Pradesh for 10 years instead of 5 years, as well as special package for the state. He also promised that the special category status to Andhra Pradesh would be extended up to 10 years if they come to power. According to National Development Council, the criteria for accorded special category status are economic backwardness, lack of proper infrastructure, non-viable nature of finances. The state of Andhra Pradesh is in fact suffering with the above three factors. First and foremost, economically, it has fallen into backward position as there are no sufficient funds for taking up any major development related actually. Secondly, there is no infrastructure because the industrially and commercially developed state capital Hyderabad has gone to Telangana. And residual Andhra Pradesh has left with no capital of its own. It has first looked for a capital city for which there are no sufficient finances. Thirdly, non-viable nature finances is also an important problem before the government. 14th Finance Commission in its report stated that Andhra Pradesh will be only state other than special category states which will suffer with revenue deficit at the end of 14th Finance Commission period 2019-20, at a time when states of Bihar, Orissa, Rajasthan and similar other backward states would be thriving with revenue surplus. Please note, sir. This means that Andhra Pradesh will continue to be the most fiscally disadvantaged state in the country. In fact, the financial imbalance can only be corrected by giving a rapid industrial and commercial development in Andhra Pradesh and also help to tide over its gapping budgetary shortfall of over 12,000 crores or more annually. In these circumstances, granting a special status and special package is the only hope for Andhra Pradesh. This will entail the flow of large amount of funds to the state by way of grants for its economic development. The industrial incentives and tax exemptions which would come through special status and special package would give a solace to Andhra Pradesh. 2014 has seen BJP come to power, yet whenever the question of special category status to Andhra Pradesh has come up in either of the houses, the government has made it clear that due to some technical problems in the passed act, granting of a special category status to Andhra Pradesh is not possible. Further, they have sent the message that instead of special category status, special package would be given. A simple reading of the Act will show the special development package has already been promised to 7 backward districts of Andhra Pradesh, which includes the 4 districts of Rayalaseema, 3 districts of Uttar Andhra. In the special package, this government is offering different from what is already promised to Andhra Pradesh under this Act. The Rayalaseema Rights United Forum has been demanding a special development package for the 7 backward districts of Rayalaseema, Uttar Andhra for more than a decade. These demands were represented at the last moment at the center of by TDP and BJP, which in turn were accepted by then ruling Congress UPA. The need for such package is highlighted in the fact that 7 districts of Rajasthan.
Only one more minute.
2 minutes.
Only one more minute.
And economic indicator that mirror special category states. These areas are, in addition to being geographical landlocked, are also severely drought prone. At present, these districts lack of economic growth and substantially poor infrastructure, and therefore unable to attract investments and kickstart their own cyclic.
Okay, thank you.
1 minute, I will conclude, sir.
No,
in view of the mentioned facts, I humbly request all the parties to come together to meet the aspiration of the people of AP, granting special status and special package to it, thereby putting an end to all such confusions. So I once again request all the members of both August houses to understand the plight of these people of Andhra Pradesh and evolve a way to grant special status.
Okay, thank you. Dr. Keshav Rao.
It was mentioned in the...
Dr. Keshav Rao.
Without any...
So, you know...